Namaste YouTube, welcome to Enoma. We are going to give our reaction to Wake Me Up When September Ends by Green Day. And let me tell you, this is one of my favorite songs.
So it's not going to be an honest reaction from Kirti. But wait a minute, I guess this is one of my favorite songs too. Yeah, but I never really looked at the lyrics.
I've
loved it. I know most of the lyrics part. And I do know what it means, but I've never really gone deeper into it because it's obviously a very emotional song and it connects with me too. This is a tribe request, by the way. It's not just our favorite. It's a favorite of a couple of our close friends. And it has been on our list of requests for a long time. Finally, we are getting down to doing it. Let's hope we can do justice to it. It's a mammoth song of Green Day. What do you think, Idala? You said it's your favorite song. What do you think it's about?
I was going to say, being very shamelessly, that, you know, I have only restricted myself to the title of the song, Wake Me Up When September Ends. That's okay. All I know about it. Okay. Nothing more.
Let's get started.
The innocent can never last. Wake me up when September ends. Like my father's come to pass, 7 years has gone so fast. Wake me up when September ends. Comes the rain again, falling from the stars, drenched in my pain again, becoming who we are. As my memory rests, but never forgets what I lost. Wake me up when September ends. Becoming who we are.
days linger right to the end.
Love the tune. Down, 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 down.
Yeah, you get this song when it starts. That guitar tune. Just can't forget. You know it is going to play when that starts.
You know, we talk a bit about not having great music being created in the last few decades.
Yeah.
But Green Day is one of those bands who proves us wrong every single time. They come up with such songs that, you know, they are supremely, supremely talented. You know, you won't believe this, but this song was written by him. Parts of this song were written by him when he was 10 years old, the lead vocalist of Green Day.
Yeah.
So, of course, more and more was added to it as he grew older.
And you know, Green Day is one of those bands, they're very humble.
They appear
and
to be,
they seem to be very, very humble. Because they have had great songs, massive songs, but you never see them bragging about it or, you know, showing off about it.
They're definitely legends, definitely already. They are a major, major rock band. It's just that... Yeah, you're right. We don't hear too much about them.
Yeah.
I don't think they like touring too much. I don't think they like coming out with too many albums.
They love what they do. They work.
And that it shows. It shows.
Yeah.
Whatever they're doing it well, because coming out with tunes like that and coming out with meaningful songs like that is amazing. I guess all the new bands of this generation, this era, need to take a leaf out of Green Day's book. The song is definitely one of the songs I would recommend that you all play at my funeral if I die young or if I die soon. This should be one of the songs on the playlist on my funeral. Wake Me Up When September Ends. And, you know, it's a nice song. Whenever I hear it, it gets me a little emotional. I try not to show it now because it's a song that makes me immediately think about my mom. Makes me think about my dad too, because both of them are no more with me. They're both dead. So I do think about my mom a lot more whenever I hear songs like this. So definitely it brings back a lot of good memories that I had with her, but at the same time I get very emotional too. So I try, as I said, I have heard it many times. I do know the words too, but I never really wanted to react to it or analyze it too deeply because it brings back a lot of memories which I I don't think I can do justice, you know, to the song if I show my emotions on an open forum like this. So what are your thoughts though?
I was dying to get to this, that I remember In Bloom, from Nirvana, and how Kurt Cobain wanted to say that my fans listen to me, but they don't really get it. And not only me, there are many people like that. We listen to songs, we enjoy the songs, but we don't really get it. We love the music, we love the heavy, you know, music that plays and we enjoy. But we don't really care what the meaning is. What does it really say? Is it happy? Is it sad? It is not that upbeat. What is it? What is the mood like? What the band, the singer is trying to tell us? We don't really care. I remember the song. We used to take it like a fun song, you know, wake me up when this month end and wake me up, whichever month was going on when it would play, wake me up when October ends, we would say, just for fun, we would be listening to it and having fun about it. But today is the first time that I was reading the lyrics, I was listening to the lyrics and I was trying to connect what he's actually talking about. He's talking about his father who's passed away and how he's, you know, he likes to skip September month, maybe because his father may have
passed away in September. Yeah.
So that month he doesn't want to.
Or it may have also been the time when they go spend a lot of family time.
Yeah, it may have been special month or something like that. That he wants to skip that month because it's painful for him. And I like the lines when he says, even though my memory may rest, but I won't forget what I've lost. Yeah. That is the spirit. With time, we forget about our pain, we forget about our loss, but we still know what the loss was. Mm-hmm. How much we lost when we lose loved ones, when we lose somebody who was that important and valuable to us. I mean, going with the lyrics of the song, having it on the screen, it gives me a completely different perspective about this song. earlier, whenever I heard the song with friends, with people, you know, it was a fun song with great music playing. What is common between this Green Day and Linkin Park is they go to the highest peak when the music part hits in. Yeah. Everything all together, you know, all forces together they put in. And that effect is awesome. Just love it.
Yeah, you mentioned two great bands already.
I did.
And Linkin Park, and of course we are reacting to
Green
Day.
Because for me these are...
Yeah, they are definitely the bands which definitely your generation listens to a lot more, you know, generation that is much younger to me. You all listen to it a lot more. And of course, I learn a lot from you while reacting to songs like that. Of course, it's a song of my generation too. I'm not that old. But the fact is that it's a great song. It's definitely a song that will many people will connect with. Many people who've lost their father at a young age, you know, considering he wrote it when his father passed away and he was 10, it shows that his father passed away at a very, very young age. So, you know, there are many people who this song will connect with, because we lose our parents at a very young age and at times, and then we have those memories and we do want to skip certain days or months, you know, whenever the death anniversary comes especially, we don't really want to go to the graveyard also, because at times we get very emotional and when we go there.
I kind of skip the day. I don't try to remember the day my father died. It sometimes, you know, confuses me also. But it doesn't matter because I don't want to remember it. I don't want to do anything. I have anything to do with it. Having said that, I think the song says after 7 years also, he's saying the same thing. And even 20 years also, it's the same thing.
So he would have been around 30 years old when this song was there written. Still quite young. 30 in his 30s, I guess. Yeah. Amazing song. I mean, awesome. I guess that's all there is to say. I mean, let's hear it again. And
the main instrumental part, when the guitaring comes, I think that guitar, the tune has been taken by many people in different ways, because that's an awesome piece.
Definitely.
Yeah.
Definitely. People have covered this song too. They've tried covering it or covered it too. Many young bands, new bands. Green Day has got some really good songs, and hopefully we will react to most of them. The purpose of Enoma, one of the main purposes, is to react to music of all sorts, all genres, all kinds, but specifically to music that our tribe, which means our close friends and family, likes, and then also our subscribers and patrons. So Green Day has definitely been a popular request, and hopefully we will react to a lot more of Green Day in the weeks and months to come, whether on Enoma or even in the future, if there has to be, due to the unpredictable nature of this platform, even if it's on another channel, another platform, definitely we would love to listen to and react to Green Day a lot more. That's it for this reaction. Thank you for watching and listening.